Hi, welcome to a wonderful day today. And today we are going to talk about a very interesting but very common passage in the Bible. Almost every Christian knows this passage, the parable of the sower. But I'm going to want us to look at it in a different light. That's why today's topic I'm going to call it. It's going to be a question. Which soil are you? Where do you belong in this parable? Where can you honestly from your heart place yourself in this parable? Let me read it. Let us remind ourselves of it. So that I want you to really think. Sit down after listening to this. Think about yourself and ask yourself, where in this parable do I fit in? Let us read it. So I'm going to read from the book of Luke, chapter 8. I'll start from 5 to 10, and then I'll jump to just verse 15. So those are the areas I want us to listen to. So from verse 5, a sower went out to sow his seed. And as he sowed, some fell by the wayside, and it was trodden down, and the fowls of the air devoured it. And some fell upon a rock, and as soon as it was sprung up, it withered away, because it lacked moisture. Some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up with it and choked it. And the other fell on good ground and sprang up and bore fruit in hundredfold. And when he said these things, he cried, "He that had ears to hear, let him hear." And the disciples asked him, saying, "What might this parable be?" And he said, "Unto you it is given to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God, but to others in parables, that seeing they might not see." Is it in your Bible? "That seeing they might not see, and hearing they might not understand." Why would God teach something in a way that people may see and yet will not see? Why would He teach something in a way that people will hear and yet will not understand? Why would you teach if you don't want people to understand? Why would you show people things if we don't want them to comprehend or to see it? There is a passage that says that the path that leads to death is very wide, and many go along that path, but that the path that leads to life, it's very narrow, and very few find it. The word "find" simply means that for them to see that narrow path, they would have been looking for it. They would have created time and searched out that narrow path. It is not a path that is just easy to find easily. It is a path that there is a willingness to search out. There is a desire to find out. The people that hear and do not comprehend are spectators. There are people that come to church for entertainment. There are people that come to church to show off clothes. There are people that come to church because everybody in the house is going, let me go. There are people that come to church because, oh, it's a Sunday, I have to be in church. And after the church, there are the people that are divided into the first three. Those are those that hear, but they do not understand. The first group of the people are the people that hear, and immediately they step out of the church. They don't even remember the topic. Their mind is already on something else. All they know is that they've gone to church for the day. Now, on to something else. The second group of people that fell on a rock, there are people that hear, but because they have not initially in their house practiced reading, practiced seeking to understand, they don't have roots. So immediately they hear, and there's any little challenge at all, they don't have the means to fight that challenge. So the word doesn't make any impact in their lives. And then the other third people that manage to even hear and hold it and rejoice, they become distracted by the cares of the world, by running after money, by running after comfort. They become so distracted, they don't even remember the words. They don't even have time for the word. Those are people that hear the word, but they do not understand. In these three, where do you belong? That is my teaching for today. Today is a teaching that will make you sit down and set yourself. Where do I belong? Let's look at verse 15. 15 says, but that on the good ground are they which in an honest and good heart have heard the word, have kept it, have brought forth fruit with patience. That is the fourth group. And the group that God wants you to be. A group that has heard the word. A group that has kept it. A group that has brought forth fruit. I'm not interested if you say, I am a Christian, I read God's word, I am a good soil. Where is your fruit? That is the evidence to show that you are a good soil. Where is your fruit? What have you brought forth with patience? Please, go back and read the parable of the sower. And as you read, may the Holy Spirit show you where you belong and also open your eyes to see how to improve. I pray that the Lord will open your eyes and grant you the wisdom. Till next time in Christianity 247, remain blessed.